Hello friends, so today we're gonna discuss this problem from Educational Code Forces round 89, problem A, shovels and swords. So Polycarp plays a well-known computer game, and in this game he can craft tools of two types, shovels and swords. To craft a shovel, Polycarp spends two sticks and one diamond, okay? And to craft a sword, Polycarp spends two diamonds and one stick. Each tool can be sold for exactly one emerald. How many emeralds can Polycarp earn if he has A sticks and B diamonds? Okay, so try to first use the test cases in the question or try to craft other test cases. So let's craft some test cases. As you can see, if it can be this. This can be sticks and this can be diamonds. Okay, and then it reverse can also happen. And let's just take one example, 8 and 7. For this also. Okay, now if we have two sticks and 100 diamonds, then what will be our strategy be? We will try to exhaust, because this is very small in compared to diamonds. What we can do here is we can use one stick and two diamonds, and again one stick and two diamonds. So total number of two emeralds we can get. Same in this case, we can use one diamond and two sticks, one diamond and two sticks, so two emeralds we can generate. So what we can see in these two examples is that if one of them is small enough such that if you multiply it with two, then the next or the other number should be greater than or equal to twice of this number. Why? Because you want to exhaust all this number which is the smaller. To exhaust all of this, we will require at least 2 into this number, and we have to, the number should be at least greater than this, because if we take all the sticks, for 2 sticks we required 4 diamonds, so the number of diamonds should be at least greater than or equal to 4, then we can exhaust all the sticks and the diamond also, and thus 2 is the answer for all of them. But can we do this in generalized form? Okay, so see, if you want to exhaust all the sticks, how many sticks we can form if we have 4 sticks? Then what we can do here is I can start taking out sticks and one diamond. Because there are 8 sticks, we will take 2 sticks out and one diamond. Then again 2 sticks out, one diamond, 2 sticks out, one diamond, and 2 sticks out and one diamond. So total we can get 4 emeralds, because we have taken out all the sticks and the sticks become 0. And we have taken out 4 diamonds from here, because we have taken out 8 sticks in, and thus 4 diamonds, and thus the remaining will be 3. But can we do better? Can we do better? And answer is also not 4 for this, it's also 5. So now you can understand that this logic is false. This logic can be true, but this logic is false. So how to improve and how to understand what is our problem? Because the problem comes here is that we are assuming that we are using all the only sticks and only one diamond and all two sticks. But that is wrong. We can do some other and better way also. So how we can do this? We will have to understand the concept that at every point we are taking out total of three units. Because either we are taking out two sticks and one diamond, or we will take out one diamond and two sticks. So from the total, we are taking out at every step a total of 3 units. Okay, but if we are taking out a total of 3 units at every step, can we exhaust or can we just add them and divide it by 3? And because this 3 is remaining at the end, if we do this, the total will be 15 divided by 3 and the total is 5, which is good. So now we understand why this is coming, because we are not efficiently using all our resources. Okay, so but we can see that at every step we are taking out 3 elements. If we add all of these elements, all of the total A and B, and then divide it by 3, then we can easily see that if we divide it by 3, all of the elements will be taken out either in this form or in this form, and the total will be 3. Okay, because there is no other way to get a sum of 3 using two numbers. the total number can be only 2-1 or 1-2. So there can be only these two cases only. But we are not knowing how we are taking out these cases. We just only divided by 3. Okay, so that's the logic. I'll tell you to the code now. The code is very simple also. We'll take the input of A and B. We will first check that for both of these two conditions. If we take 2 into A, if B is greater than this, then we just return A. Else if we will check whether 2 into B is, if A is greater than 2 into B, then we print B. Else what we will do is, we will see out A plus B divided by 3. So that's the whole logic. I hope you understand the code as well as the logic. If you still have any doubts, please mention down. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see the next one. Keep coding. Bye.